Well, your friend or family member has an idea now for a startup. The idea may sound cool, but how do you know if it's a really a viable investment choice? For insight now on making that decision, we are joined on set by Laurence Schreiber of Clarity Capital. Thanks very much for being with us.
Hi, Natalie. Thanks for having me.
Well, does this happen a lot? Do you hear about this a lot, of investors being approached by acquaintances, friends, or family members to back their startup ideas or product ideas?
Absolutely. I think it's a very common theme now that once someone is known to be a successful investor or even just a wealthy person, they're constantly approached by brothers-in-law, by wife's or husband's second cousins, even by a gardener or electrician, to say, I've got this idea. I've got this great concept. I'm building this thing. Do you want to participate with me? And it actually is very common, and it's not easy to deal with necessarily.
Well, how do you advise your clients to navigate around this potentially very messy situation?
Sure. Well, the first part is that sometimes it's very tempting. We've all heard so many stories about companies like Apple Computer that started in a garage, and it's very tempting to think maybe this is the next Google, or maybe this is the next big thing. But the reality is, for every one real success story, there are probably 10,000 companies that fail. So we typically will advise our clients to really try and avoid making an allocation to something based on an emotional connection. Really try and be thoughtful about the potential for a realistic return on your investment.
That's an excellent point you make, because I think that there's this common statistic out there that 1 in 10 businesses only make it out when they first start out. But when do personal and direct investments actually make sense here?
So I think the exception to that rule would be an area where you really have personal experience or expertise. So for example, if you're a real estate developer and someone brings you a real estate investment, you probably have some tools to make that work. Or potentially if you're an expert in biology or biosciences and someone's looking at a more life sciences related opportunity, somewhere where you can actually firsthand provide knowledge, you're much more likely to make a good decision. Otherwise, it's probably something you want to avoid.
All right, good point there as well. But what do you think about this in general, having a private investment in most private investors' portfolios in general?
A great question. There is certainly a role for private investing, whether it's private loans, private equity companies. The issue is that individuals who don't see hundreds and hundreds of these deals at a time shouldn't be making those choices. If you have a professional investment advisor, though, who has an expertise or their team has an expertise in looking at private investments, the fact that private loans and private companies are not directly correlated to your other more liquid investments like stocks and bonds can be a good addition to your portfolio.
Well, thank you very much for bringing that to our attention. Very much appreciate it. Here from New York.
Correct.
Laurence Schreiber.
Thank you very much, Natalie.